Hi, Carl Winkler here at Lectrosonics. In this video, I'll explain the details of our high-density transmission mode so that you'll know when to use this powerful tool and what to expect. HDM is one of the compatibility modes now available in some of our transmitters and all of our digital receivers. HDM is a combination of low RF power and smaller occupied bandwidth for those situations when you need to get more channels into less spectrum. The design goal was to allow more than 24 channels into 6 MHz or less of clean spectrum with excellent sound quality and reasonable range, and we've achieved that. Because of the lower RF power, this mode is likely to be most useful in a controlled environment like a studio or stage where you can optimize antenna placement and ensure correct RF gain structure. Standard ETSI-compliant RF carriers take up about 200 kHz of occupied bandwidth. HDM, on the other hand, takes up half of that, or 100 kHz, and allows for much tighter channel spacing. And, when selecting this mode on the transmitter, the RF power is set at 2 milliwatts, resulting in extremely low intermod products, even when multiple units are physically close together. The transmitter-to-transmitter IM products are below the noise floor, and thus do not have to be considered when coordinating frequencies. Because of this, carriers can not only be closely spaced, but also evenly spaced. For our tests with actual systems, we started with 24 DBSM transmitters, then did a second test with 40 transmitters, all placed 18 inches apart, all together in one room. We spaced the carriers evenly at 200 kHz apart and still had normal operation. In some situations, even closer spacing might be possible, but operating range is reduced, depending on external conditions. So that your receivers operate correctly with this mode and include the correct filtering, please be sure to update the firmware in your dsqd, dchr, and dcr822 to the latest versions, which include HDM mode as a compatibility selection. We recommend you check the firmware history pages on our website for the latest updates. Note that with half the occupied bandwidth, and thus a reduced data rate, the HDM mode has a slightly reduced upper frequency response. D2 mode provides flat response from below 20 Hz to 20 kHz, while HDM tops out at 16 kHz. The proprietary codec we developed for this mode yields excellent sound quality, though. You may be hard-pressed to hear a difference between the two modes in most situations. You may be concerned about operating range with such low RF power. We optimize this mode for channel density while maintaining excellent sound quality. That said, you might be surprised at the range you can get with this system on a clean frequency. Here's a little walk test we did using the DBSM and HDM mode and a DCR822 with whip antennas. All right, so we're outside. We're going to do the classic walk test. I'm going to walk out that way. Don't know if I'm going to see any roadrunners today, but we'll find out. All right, let's see what happens. Okay, got some different sagebrush out here. A little breezy, hopefully not too bad. Walking in between the sages here. Got to get out to the end of the property over here, see how we're doing. Beautiful day out here today, mid-March. Nice and sunny, a little breezy, not too bad. Not fully in the windy season yet. Okay. And I'd say this is about 100 yards away. So 100 yards, and I'm gonna turn around and start heading back your way. Yeah, no roadrunners this time. That was a fun one, the one with the setting your transmitter gain properly. By the way, with digital transmitters, gain settings don't change range at all, but it's still a good idea to have good gain structure for good audio. Okay, we'll have to see how we did. In many cases, omni antennas will outperform directionals when using this mode due to the increased pickup from reflected RF signals. Some additional things to consider. Be sure to let wireless designer do your frequency coordination when possible. Don't forget to update it to the latest version, at least 2.0.31 for Windows and 2.0.26 for Mac OS, so it knows what to do with channels in HDM. And, of course, please use best practices for antenna placement, RF gain structure, and filtering for best results. These things are more critical when using low RF power. Because the human body absorbs RF energy, be sure to use some of the common tips and tricks for keeping transmitter antennas away from skin and not covered by limbs or metallic fabrics. I covered this important topic in my video about the 7 most common problems with wireless mic systems and how to solve them. As you can see, high-density mode is a powerful tool when you've got the antenna system, the RF gain structure, and the environment to make the most of this low-power mode. We were able to get more than 24 channels to fit into 6 MHz. Let's see what you can do with it. For more information on the latest Lectrosonics digital wireless systems, please visit lectrosonics.com. And don't forget to check out the other technical videos we have on our YouTube channel. Don't forget to like and subscribe. I'm Carl Winkler. Thanks for watching.